next guest is best known as the Wicked Witch of the West, and today musical theatre superstar Jemma joins us now live in the studio. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. Now,
Thank you for having me.
Audiences right around Australia as your role as the Wicked Witch. How is that to play?
Look, it's fun because I get to play an evil character, and you always want to play a villain. They're more fun than the sweet characters. But I've had a lot of experience playing Wicked.
Being Wicked.
But I was in Wicked for 7 years. And so then,
was it 7 years?
Yeah, really long time. And so now I'm playing the Wicked Witch in The Wizard of Oz. So, yeah, I'm very experienced.
You're not worried about
this.
Being typecast.
That's it, yeah. My husband, he doesn't really appreciate me being a witch all the time, but, you know.
This sounds stupid, but what's it like being green all the time?
It's not great for the skin,
yeah.
but it is a MAC makeup, so it is a proper makeup. It's not like green paint. But yeah, it's quite difficult to get all the green off, that's for sure, and it gets in my ears, as you can see from that picture. And also, this is from the Wizard of Oz. Red
oh,
shoes,
you look
blues.
Fabulous.
Yeah. I sing all about those ruby slippers.
It must be fun, though, as you say, to play a villain. And the
Wizard of Oz.
I'm thinking about the Wicked Witch, and she still gives me nightmares.
Yes.
And are you a scary on stage?
Well,
that sort of character?
I try to be, but I actually did all my preparation on Margaret Hamilton, who played that character from the classic. And what happened was I got into rehearsal and the director said to me, we're not going to go that direction. And I think it's because she was so wonderful. You don't want to replicate something like that. So I actually got to find my own witch.
Your inner witch.
My inner witch.
Which is what?
Well, she's a little bit more sassy, a little bit more sexy. Strangely enough, if you saw with those costumes there, there's some feathers and some green legs that come out. And, yeah, she dances a little
bit. She's still got stripy socks.
Yeah. So the Wicked Witch of the East has the stripy socks.
Oh, but that's right. She's the one under the house.
That's it.
You're right.
She's the one that got squished. Yeah, yeah.
Have you got a cat?
No, I don't. I don't. Actually, I should have done that. Method
yes.
acting. Yeah.
Jemma, this production of The Wizard of Oz is an Andrew Lloyd Webber version of The Wizard of Oz.
Yeah.
So there are some extra songs in it, not just the ones from the movie, is that right?
Yeah.
And so you've got some new numbers. Of course, we remember you doing Defying Gravity and Wicked, which was just sensational, and you nailed it and it was beautiful. But what have you got in the new one?
Yeah, well, that was what got me excited about the show, was the fact that it's still the classic film, but then those extra songs that were kind of needed, I think, really, for the witch, both witches. So Lucy Durack, who plays Glinda, sings a song as well, and Anthony Warlow is Professor Marvel, and he has a song too. And it just heightens it that little bit more, and it gives the audience is something a little bit new and fresh, but with the classic that they know and love.
Jemma, you were saying before you did prep earlier looking at other people that have played the role, but is there anything else that you do, like after a performance, you think that didn't work or this did work?
Oh, all the time. You're constantly editing yourself. But the thing is, you've got to be free when you're on stage, and then after it's done, you make that, oh, that didn't work or this didn't work. So absolutely, you're always growing. Mm. Even though you're saying the same lines every day, you want it to be fresh.
Do you practice being Wicked?
Oh, yeah, I cackle all the time.
Another
one? Oh, sure.
Yeah. Wow. That is very good. And of course, you work with the lovely Lucy Durack, who's a friend of the show, who we love very much, and a friend of mine. She's a bit annoying, though, isn't she? She's so nice.
Yeah, but that's really lovely because, you know, you spend a lot of time together.
Is it nice being back with her?
It's so nice because in this industry, you don't know when you're going to work together again. And so when we both got the call, we both called each other and said, are you going to do it? I'll do it if you do it. Yeah, we're going to do it. And so we're working together. And on stage, we have such great chemistry. And off stage, we have so much fun. So it's working with a friend. It's brilliant.
Oh, isn't it? That's the best of both worlds. Now, you've also got an album.
Yes. Yeah, Gravity. So I produced that myself.
Well done.
Thank you.
It's a way to do it.
Yeah, independent project. And it did really well. So I did some live concerts as well with it. And they're musical theatre songs with a pop edge. So they're connected with me and my musical theatre journey so far with the songs that I've selected. So I get to sing a song this afternoon. Later this morning for you guys.
Oh, fantastic. Wow. Right.
Meantime, just sum up for us the thrill of being in a live production like this? I mean, when you said you played Elphaba for 7 years and now you're doing this, what keeps you going back?
Yeah, I think it is. It's audiences and it's their response. And also particularly with this show, at stage door after we finish, we get to meet some of the audience members that want their program signed. And you're getting to see the people that have grown up with The Wizard of Oz also then teaching their children about The Wizard of Oz, and they're all dressed up in characters. Dorothy, they have their little Totos. So you're seeing these magical moments and you're part of that experience, and that never wears off.
And just quickly, Jemma, how is work progressing on the flying monkeys?
Oh, yeah.
Is that actually...
Yeah, they've taken flight. Yeah, they have. Yeah, good. They do what I tell them.
That will happen. We're looking at, 2019.
There's definitely some flying happening in the show.
Jemma, well done, and thank you so much for joining us this morning. Mm. And Jemma's fantastic album, as she mentioned, Gravity, is out now and available on iTunes. Plus, The Wizard of Oz is in Sydney and it's fabulous. And heading to Adelaide and Melbourne. For all the details, head to wizardofozthemusical.com. And the lovely Jemma, as she mentioned, is going to stick around and perform a very special song for us later this morning. See you in a moment, Jemma. Thank you very much.